Aloha, friends. So before we get to the word, as usual, if you can please like this video, subscribe to my channel, that would be great. We want to share the word with as many people as possible, especially since the time is nearer now than it was before. So let's get to the word. So the Lord has really been speaking to me a lot about vision. And it's not the superhero from Marvel, but we're talking about vision from Webster's 1828, good old Webster's. It says the act of seeing external objects, actual sight. And I love that it says faith here is turned into vision there. And you know, that's what faith is. It's the confidence of things hoped for, the evidence, the physical evidence of things we cannot see yet. And another definition that was in Webster's 1828 for vision is in scripture, a revelation from God, an appearance or exhibition of something supernaturally presented to the minds of the prophets by which they were informed of future events. Such were the visions of Isaiah, Amos, Ezekiel, etc. And God was speaking to me both about vision and revelation, and they kind of go hand in hand or can be synonyms to each other. But revelation is, again, Webster's 1828, it says the act of disclosing or discovering to others what was before unknown to them. Appropriately, the disclosure or communication of truth to men by God himself or by his authorized agents, the prophets and apostles. So God was telling me the difference between the two. And while revelation is so important, personal revelation is super important, it's really important to have personal vision and corporate vision too, but especially personal vision. And revelation is more about like what we receive from God, which is not a bad thing. We definitely want to receive and get a download from God of the things to come. But also it puts the focus on us. And vision is where we keep our eyes. It's where we keep our focus. More importantly, who we keep our focus on. So Proverbs 29:18, and I'm reading from the New Living Translation. It says, when people do not accept divine guidance, they run wild. But whoever obeys the law is joyful. And in the Amplified Version, the same verse says, where there is no vision, no revelation of God and his word, the people are unrestrained. But happy and blessed is he who keeps the law of God. And I believe it's NIV that says, where there is no vision, the people perish. So where there's no vision or personal revelation of God, people run wild, they're unrestrained, they perish. We have to catch a vision of God, of who he is, of the amazing things that he can do. That's why we acknowledge, we thank him, we give gratitude of the things that he's already done and the things that he's gonna do. And it's not our vision either. It's the vision received from God himself. And I just want to really quickly emphasize how we receive that vision. It's by the Holy Spirit. The Bible says that the Spirit of God searches even the deep things of God. And it's by the Spirit that things are revealed to us from God himself. And so I would encourage you to read 1 Corinthians 12. It talks about the gifts of the Spirit. But I just want to really quickly read, starting in verse 7. This is from NLT. It says, a spiritual gift is given to each of us so we can help each other. To one person, the Spirit gives the ability to give wise advice. To another, the same Spirit gives a message of special knowledge. The same Spirit gives great faith. To another, gifts of healing. To another, miracles. To another, the ability to prophesy. He gives someone else the ability to discern. Still another, the ability to speak in unknown languages. Another is given the ability to interpret what he said. And in verse 11, it says, it is the one and only Spirit who distributes all these gifts. He alone decides which gift each person should have. So I would encourage you, spend some time with the Holy Spirit. It's so important to have a relationship with him. Super important. Jesus is important. God is important. The Holy Spirit is the one who reveals all things to us. So catch his vision. Ask him for his vision. Love you with the Jesus love.